Five Rights website.
Joining us on the Five Spotlight today is Leah Johnson and Katie Kutzko from the Five Rights News, our online publication. These ladies had the chance to intern at the Indianapolis Star this week. What stories did you cover?
We covered House Bill 1402, which is a bill that states any student in the state of Indiana that's undocumented won't be able to receive in-state tuition or scholarships or federal aid.
Well, that sounds like there's a lot of research that goes into that. So what research did you go through to get that story?
Well, the first day that we went out, we did some man on the street, which is just, we went downtown in Indianapolis and talked to random people. We just stopped them in their everyday life and just asked them questions. And then the next day we went, did man on the street again at IUPUI, talked to random students, and we also just like read through the bill just so we had a better understanding of it.
What was that experience like for you guys to go out and ask people that you do not know, who don't know you from anybody, and ask them questions? What was that like?
It takes you completely out of your comfort zone, because there's people that don't want to talk to you first off. They don't know you. You don't come from a publication that they're familiar with. So sometimes they don't give you their names, their age, where they come from. So it's difficult, for sure.
You know, and whether you're in print, broadcast, radio, you have to go out and chase those stories, and you have to deal with people who don't want to talk to you. So did that at all change your outlook on the field of journalism? Is this still something that you want to do?
Yes, it's definitely something I still want to do, if not more. This kind of encouraged it, because I got a real taste of what it's really like in the real world. Because we spend our time working alongside someone at the Indianapolis Star, so it was really cool.
All right, and we're going to all be looking forward to hearing all about your experience in the Five Rights News online publication. You can check it out on our website.
Hello, I'm Danica Newsom, and here with us is Hayden Sigelski, one of our Five Rights reporters. Hayden, tell us about the opportunity that you had this week.
I had the opportunity to go to the Indianapolis Recorder, and I wrote two articles while I was there, one about the feather trend and one about pediatricians.
How did you go about writing about the feather trend?
I talked to teenagers who make feather jewelry and people who have dream catchers and who have also put feathers in their hair.
Okay, what about the pediatricians? How did you go about writing about that?
I talked to a new family who just had a baby, and I also talked to the Wishard Health Services, who let me talk to one of their doctors.
Okay. Which story did you like writing about more?
I liked writing about the feathers more because it was my opinion, and it was easier. It just flowed better for me.
What did you gain from the IABJ workshop?
I met a lot of people. I made a lot of friends, and the experience at the Indianapolis Recorder was an awesome experience to see how journalism in like the real world versus high school journalism.
What are some differences that you realized between high school journalism and real world journalism?
I think the deadlines, I think, are the biggest difference, just the importance of them.
Hayden, thank you so much for coming in and telling us about your experience. For more information about Hayden's articles or any of the stories written this week, you can visit our website. Five Rights News will return after these messages.
16 young journalists explore the world of journalism in the workshop provided by IABJ that included internships at the most respected corporations in the state. Even though it's tough at times, we use our togetherness and pulled it all together. These experiences definitely helped us ease on down the road to success.
Jonna, what have you found?
Well, the Metropolitan Police Department and the Marion County Sheriff's Department and other departments, they're setting up programs and services to get to the policemen to help reduce the stress of their day-to-day jobs.
How many people will this affect? Are there people still out on the streets? The officers are in the streets. Have they been withdrawn to the offices? What is the plan of action?
Well, actually, it depends on how high their stress level is. If they're able to cope with it and still do their job, then they're able to do their regular assignments. Some are taken off the force and they're reduced their assignments. Some are given temporary assignments so they can reduce their stress level. It all depends on how high their stress is.
Is everyone given a second chance to prove themselves that they're rehabilitated, or is there at some point that the department says, we just have to let you go?
Yes, everybody is given a second chance. It's not like you do extreme measures and they take you off. It's you see if you can reduce it, and if you can't, then they'll take you off of somewhat, and they'll help you with it. That's if you want help. It's your choice.
All right, well, we will find out the rest of her report in the upcoming edition of Five Rights News Online.
Let's now send it to Debbie with our entertainment buzz news.
Hello, Five Rights fans. I'm Debbie Ruiz here today with your entertainment news. You knew him when he played for the Pacers. Now, LA Lakers star Ron Artest has scheduled a petition for name change. Now, we all know in the past he's had his ups and downs and for the infamous throwdown in Motown. But Ron Artest is trying to do a 180 by changing his name to Metta World Peace. Let me break it down for those who don't know. Metta is a Buddhist term meaning a strong wish for the welfare and happiness of others. Now, moving along, is the crew of the Jersey Shore finished? Several online websites claim the whole Jersey Shore crew is going to be replaced. Now, don't be sad, Jersey Shore fans. MTV denies all these claims. A spokesperson for the network says, quote, "We currently have no plans to recast the show." MTV also has signed deals with Snooki, JWoww, and DJ Pauly D for Jersey Shore spinoff shows, so it would be pointless to replace these crazy Guidos and Guidettes. And finally, according to US Weekly, Kim Kardashian's ex Reggie Bush has found a new sweetheart, which happens to be a replica of Kim herself. Are you missing her much, Reggie? The look-alike Melissa Molinaro became known from the super cute Old Navy ad. Hey Reggie, check Melissa's IQ. Could be Kim after all. Well, that's all for me here in entertainment.
Let's check out what's happening in sports this week with David Shealy.
Well, June was a great month for the NBA. We had the Dallas Mavericks win their first ever championship against the much-hyped Miami Heat. And most recently, the NBA draft on Thursday. But July looks like it will be the complete opposite.
The NBA collective bargaining agreement expires on July 1st. Negotiations will begin shortly, but they will definitely not end shortly. NBA owners are getting too greedy for money. The players' money. I talked to a member of Indiana Pacers center, Roy Hibbert's Area 55, Connor Wilder. Connor has supported the Pacers most of his life.
I've been a fan ever since Reggie Miller was on the Pacers, and I was really fortunate to be a fan and be able to watch him in the playoffs for years.
Right now, the players are receiving 57% of the NBA income, and the owners are attempting to change that to 50% so they can get the other half to themselves. I told Connor of the owners' hope for a percentage of the players' money.
I actually think it's just fine as it is.
I also talked to Jeff Smullyan, the chairman of the board for MS Communications and an NBA insider. He said the owners want too much money back, and when it comes to the heat of the negotiations, he added, on a scale of 1 to 10, it's a 10. Also, regarding the effects an NBA lockout would have on the rookies and free agents, he said, everything will be frozen. David Shealy, Five Rights News.
The NBA held its annual draft this past Thursday, and for the Indiana Pacers, a former Indiana native is coming back home to play for them. George Hill was traded to the Pacers for the 15th overall pick, Kawhi Leonard, and the 42nd overall pick, Davis Bertans. Hill went to Broad Ripple High School and graduated from IUPUI. Other Hoosiers had their share of the spotlight during the draft. Butler University star Shelvin Mack was drafted in the second round to the Washington Wizards. His teammate Matt Howard is still waiting to be drafted. Purdue star Juwan Johnson was traded to the Boston Celtics after being drafted by the New Jersey Nets. He'll join his Purdue teammate Etwan Moore in Boston.
Thanks, David. You know, it'll certainly be disappointing if we don't know if the Pacers will make it to next year's playoffs. We have to have some Hoosier basketball, something that hopefully isn't disappointing. This week's forecast, and here's Princess Kimbrough with the latest.
Hello, I'm meteorologist Princess, and today Our temperature right now is 72 degrees. Our humidity level is 68%. Today's high is going to be 74 and our low was 66. We're going to jump to Friday, and in the morning it'll be cooler, 60 degrees. The afternoon will be 70, sunny, and the evening will be 74. Saturday, we're going to have 64 degrees. It'll be a little cooler in the morning. The afternoon will be 74 degrees, and the evening will be 79. And this week, it'll be warm and dry. And early this week, it'll be warmer with the chance of rain. Let's look at our week forecast.
Tuesday and Wednesday both have a high of 90 and lows in the 70s. Thursday is a 40% chance of storms with a high of 87 and a low of 70.
I'm Princess Kimbrough, and that was your Right Weather 5, where 5 days out of the week were right and the other two, no's.
Some cool, challenging, and inspiring week here. We want to thank the Indianapolis Association of Black Journalists, Butler University, and all the news outlets and public relations firms that welcomed us through their doors.
We enjoyed shadowing reporters and public relations executives at Wish TV, WTHR, WRTV, WIBC-FM, Borshoff, the Indianapolis Star, and the Indianapolis Recorder.
We know that our journey here will allow us to be success stories wherever we go. For IABJ's Multimedia Workshop, we'll see you all next year. Good night.